So my neighbor Reg, who lives across the street from me, showed me his wooden jointer, and I thought, that looks awfully familiar. And I'd seen it in Fine Woodworking, right here, and they even have plans for it. This is from 1981.
At that time, I think I was subscribing to Fine Woodworking, and I was lucky enough to be working at a high school that had a complete shop set up. And a friend of mine and I had just bought 3,000 feet of board feet of red oak, so we were looking for projects to do. So anyways, I found that article on Fine Woodworking, so we decided, well, let's try to make a jointer. I had access to all the tools, and that's including even the head. I was lucky enough to be right across the hallway from the machine shop, and the teachers on that side were good enough to show me how to use the different milling machines, and that's how that came about.
Unlike my homemade jointer design, the table is solid wood and it's laminated together out of a whole lot of pieces and is very thick, which helps to ensure it's flat. And we were just checking it, it's still quite flat. The head on this one is a 3-inch head and it's on pillow blocks. And he actually had that milled out of a raw piece of steel, which is kind of funny because if you had to get a head like that milled nowadays, that would probably cost you more than just buying a jointer. The tables adjust on four slides here and here. And what's a little bit awkward about this one is there's a wing nut down in here for locking the table in place. So that needs to be loosened before that table can be lowered with a nice wooden crank on here. And this doesn't necessarily slide on its own. Going up, it's much easier. There. Very nice and solid. The motor is behind the machine in this thing that kind of sticks out the side. And this is, there we go. 1 horsepower, 1750 RPM motor goes up to a pulley up here, and you can see the upper pulley is a bit smaller to run that head faster than the motor. Probably about 3000 RPM, I'd say. And then on the front, it has a chip compartment, which is really cool. And that's one reason not to put the motor down here, so that there's room for the chip compartment. And then the fence is got this extension sort of table on here that it rests on, which is kind of a cool idea in terms of having a good support for it. On my homemade jointer, I don't have as much sticking out here because I didn't want to take up that space, but down here's the motor already sticking out. So this makes sense. This is a very solid support for that fence. And the guard, of course, which I think I just lowered the table so much, so now it's riding on, yeah, it's stuck on the upper table. Let's bring that up a bit. And now it works a bit better.
What I really find kind of interesting is I got out of woodwork altogether probably 25 years ago. So this thing sat in my garage for 25 years, and then just a couple of years ago, as my interest came back, I plugged it in, I dusted it off, plugged it in, and away she went.
Let's give this thing a whir. I like the sound of it. It sounds a lot like my dad's 12-inch jointer. Not whiny like mine based on a thickness planer. And Reg has a nice high quality straight edge. And this is good. I can't tell that it's bowed in any way. Very impressive. And we've actually been checking this whole jointer with the straight edge here. And the tables are well lined up and the outfeed table is quite flat. The infeed table actually bows down quite a bit in the middle. So the funny thing about jointers is you can joint things a lot flatter than the jointer is itself. In that 1981 Fine Woodworking article, Galen Winchip said that it cost him $350 to build this jointer. That would be $930 in today's dollars, more than it costs to buy a new 6-inch jointer. Now Reg's jointer is an 8-inch jointer, which costs more, but to really make sense in today's money, you have to build a 12-inch jointer, because those cost quite a lot more.